So, tea, breakfast. Badu kari lidu because we have a food court here. You can have tea and snacks and coffee or whatever. Ung udi gai che? Are you having a good time? Are you enjoying Gujarat Literature Festival 2016? So, once again, this year, we are here with Gujarat Literature Festival 2016, 4th edition. મારું નામ પ્રણેતા છે અને હવે આપણી સાથે એક બહુ જ ઇન્ટરેસ્ટિંગ સેશન કરવાના છે સાવી શર્મા. એમણે એક બહુ જ સરસ બુક લખી છે, એવરી વન હેઝ અ સ્ટોરી. તમને બધાને ખબર હશે કે આપણી પાસે આપણી પણ એક સ્ટોરી હોય છે, એવી રીતે બીજાની પણ હોય. So the thing about that is Savi Sharma che, she is 24 years old, very young, 23, very young, ane cafe ma baisi ne e badani stories observe kare che ane pachi emne apna sudhi pochadva mate everyone has a story lakhi che. The thing is ke aa je book che e emne emni jate publish kari che. અને 100 દિવસમાં 1 લાખ જેટલી કોપીઝ વેચાઈ. ત્યારબાદ વેસ્ટલેન્ડ પબ્લિશર્સે એને એક્વાયર કરી. તો આજે આપણે સાવી સાથે એમની જર્ની વિશે વાત કરીશું. આપણી સાથે જુમાના શાહ છે, જે સાવી સાથે ઇન્ટરેસ્ટિંગ કન્વર્સેશન કરશે. જુમાના,
થેન્ક્સ પ્રનેતા.
Hello.
Good morning, everyone. I'll introduce myself. My name is Jumana Shah. I am the executive editor of DNA in Ahmedabad. I'm a career journalist and I'm also one of the organizers of the Gujarat Literature Festival. Very happy to see you all here. A very good morning and welcome to the session. Savi Sharma, as Praneta introduced, is a very young author, a complete surprise as a lot of people have put it very simply, and she has a very simple story and a very interesting story. As Praneta said, and I'll repeat it for effect more than anything else, that she self-published her story. She was so confident about her story that she self-published it. After that, it was and she broke a record, making it the fastest selling bestseller ever, of selling 100,000 copies in 100 days on Amazon. And she has a story in that also, how she managed to do that, and that's what I'm going to bring it out of her right now. So we'll begin that. Savi, tell me, how was it? How did you identify your story first and foremost? What is it that makes you so convinced about the story?
Sinjuma, my story is very much personal. Like, it's not real. I won't say the story is very much real, but yeah, it's based on real life incidents and real life experiences. And so when I completed this book, and I was very satisfied, and I knew that it's very personal, so it's very true. And I felt that, you know, every person have somewhere such stories in their hearts. So that's the, you know, the starting lines of my books are there. Everyone has a story to tell. Everyone is a writer. Some are written in the books and some are confined to hearts. So I wanted people to share their stories which are confined to their hearts. And that's why I self-published it. I knew that, you know, there is something in the book. I knew that my readers, and they can be, you know, they'll be touched by the story. And thus I self-published it myself. I contacted printers directly and I said them that this is my story. I want to get it printed. I didn't even, considered any self-publishing houses or anything. I just get it from printers, printed done. And then I made my seller account on Amazon, and I pushed, promoted my book from Facebook purposely, only Facebook. So it was like that. And that's how my story reached people.
Think of it, it's an online phenomenon actually. And only a young person as young as 23 years old can really believe in it. Would any of us think that we can actually be a phenomenon in the country by just publishing online? Can we believe that? I wouldn't. I wouldn't have believed it had I not known it. So, Savi, how about giving a little outline of the story? Because a lot of people may not have read this book here.
The story has 4 characters, Meera, Vivan, Nisha and Kabir. So, Meera is an HR manager, but she wants to write a story which can touch millions of hearts, just like me. Then it's Vivan, he's a bank manager. He has an urge to travel and to, you know, look all world, how it is, and to find the hidden secrets of the world. So he wants to just travel. He wants to leave his job as a bank manager and wants to travel. Then there's Kabir, he's a cafe manager, but he has his own dreams and he wants to have something of his own. Then there's Anisha, she is just a sweet, simple girl, a guest wanting customer in the cafe, and she has all her own secrets, her own fights, and how they all meet, and then how their stories intertwine with each other, and how they help each other to complete each other's stories. That's what the story is all about.
The main character, Vivan, has a traveling bug in his feet. So he cannot stay stuck to one place and he has to move around. At the same time, he falls in love. And that is how the story goes on. And it's an interesting and complex plot, if I may put it that way. Savi, would you say something about that? How did you get the inspiration for a character like Vivan? Do you know somebody like that?
Well, I think even that is somewhat inspired from my life. I want to travel. The love point, that's not yet happened in my life yet. So there's no Vivan in my life. But yeah, I've met person like Vivan many. Who's doing something but who wants to do something else, if not travel, something else, but they're quite scared that when that day will come and what should they do, should they leave something permanent and go for it or not. So that's how Vivan's character came.
So the main character, another main character, I'm sorry, is Meera, who actually writes the story. She is the main protagonist in the book. So Meera sits in a cafe and writes the book, most of a book actually. Which just brings us to another facet of modern Indian life, cafes, and the role they play in a social milieu. Savi, you are also, you belong to a generation which, you know, thinks of cafes as a very important part of your life, what you do. Frankly, I wouldn't say that I'm older, but yes, I am. And when I was probably your age, I did not think of cafes as a very important place in your life where things happen. It's a place that you go and you just, you know, do, if you don't have anything better to do, you probably go there. But I never would have thought that you get a life muse from a cafe. Talk about how life it is for you. What is life in a cafe?
See, cafe is a place where we can meet different people and we see different people, the different lives. Like even in malls, I sit in cafes, sometimes I sit in malls and, you know, just on a bench and I just observe people around. So cafe is something where you meet different people every hour. You'll get two different people over there and you can see them and, you know, you can observe them. Just by observing, you learn many things from them, just by observing people. So that's what, so cafe is very important these days because people are, you know, they are getting away from natural things. Like I personally, I want to be near ocean, near water. Like I'm very much, you know, Mother Nature. I really want to, but basically, as in Surat, I don't get very much, very beautiful of Mother Nature. I go to cafes and there I find my stories.
Very interesting. Another interesting part which I'm not sure if Pranita mentioned, Savi is from Surat. So, and she has done her research in Surat, if I'm not mistaken, more or less, right? So she's brought up in Surat. Yes, so that is another aspect of her life and her persona as well, as which is brought in the book. That it brings the story of a Gujarat city. Gujarat, incidentally, is one of those states which has the highest number of urban population, one of the highest number. So I think we are well placed to write a story on evolving cafe culture from Gujarat, sorry, no less. Okay, Savi, so another aspect of your story is how you went from self-publishing on Amazon and then making it popular. There was a part where, you know, you were reaching out to all your readers and trying to take their feedback. Tell us about that.
As I told you that I used Facebook completely. So I just, I made few beautiful images of the quotes of my books. And from my book, the quotes, so I just posted that on Facebook and people, it keeps on reaching to different people. Because Facebook is something, it's very viral. If you use it correctly, it's the best thing you will get from social media. So it reached people, many people, and they started messaging me. And when I promoted my quotes on Facebook, you can promote people, targeting audience and that. And at that time, I was a bestseller on Amazon. It was number one in all categories, my book, and I've sold 5,000 copies in less than a month. And then being number one, you know, publishers, big, all traditional publishers, they always have an eye on what's on number one. So publishers like Penguin, Westland and others, they contacted me to republish my book with them. And that's how I end up with wrestling. Yeah.
There was a time when you were also talking to your readers personally. You would sort of call them and ask them for a feedback.
See, my readers, they message me on Facebook and they send me emails. And I respond to each and every message personally. So that helps me to know that, you know, what my story is and how they are taking it. And how they are getting inspired from my story and how I can improve myself. So it really helps. And I think the best part of me and my story, that is that I connect to my readers personally, and that's how I can improve myself, knowing their feedback.
Savi herself being a young person, and her character Meera is also her first character and also a reflection of herself. So Savi, something about Meera and you, and how much of you is in Meera?
I think more than 90%.
90%,
yeah, only that Meera has Vivan in her life, and Meera has long, beautiful hair. So that's the thing I don't have. Everything else is very much personal between me and Meera. Yeah, even she wants to write something which can touch millions of hearts. And actually, I feel Meera's character is very much from within. It's not something I got from outside. So she's very much personal. So if you want to know Savi, I think Meera can tell you about Savi very much.
Another interesting facet is that her book has just been translated in Gujarati and it is being released right now. So we, yeah, shall we do the honor?
Yeah, sure.
Translated your book, Savi, if I may ask?
Teacher Acharya, yeah. From Yatra.
From Yatra, okay, great. Savi, would you like to open the floor for questions for a bit and then we can come back to our conversation?
Yeah, sure, that will be better. Okay, you can ask your questions. Yeah, please. Just a second.
Ma'am, if you can tell about the process of self-publishing, steps involved.
Yeah, steps for it. If you want to, you want to go through self-publishing houses, so you can search for self-publishing houses in India on Google and you'll get many. And from there, you can check packages of various self-publishing houses. They have their packages online only on their website. So whatever meets your criteria, whatever you want to get from them and whatever package suits you, you can contact them and get your book published from there.
So somebody in the back.
Hello.
Hi.
I have just read on the Facebook that your next book is coming on 14th February, right?
Yes.
Can you give some glimpse, any idea what it will be about?
I won't say
any
what.
Any clue?
It will be again an inspirational tale about following your dreams and giving life a chance, and to give yourself a chance, and you know, to move ahead in life, you have to leave your past and you have to leave something which is holding you, and you have to take a step ahead. So again, it will be an inspirational tale, and more is coming on Facebook. Be there.
I'm also a student of journalism and I have also written one book, so
okay.
I'm just clear about that. How can I publish my book? Because at least 100 pages are written, but I'm scared. So can you please tell me how can I reach towards my book to people? Like, I have written that book and how can I publish? Because I am scared about that, whether it will good or not. That's why.
Firstly, you have to be confident.
Yeah.
That's the first point. And see, if you want to publish a novel, you have to write more. 100 pages are pretty less. You at least have to write around 175 to 200 pages. So work on your story more. Be confident and trust on your words. If you have written something, there must be something.
Actually, I have written about the mindset about boys and girls.
Okay.
So current scenario which we have facing in current days. So I am just care about that. How can I publish that? Because I have talked with many of the publishers. They told me that your story is good, but first you have to publish in the social media site. That's why I am just care about that.
See, 100 pages are actually less. Publishers won't publish your book, 100 pages book. So you have to write more. make it around 200 pages, and then you can contact publishers again with your story. Yeah.
Did you always wanted to become a writer, or how did you get into this writing stuff?
As far as author is concerned, from the first year of my college, I thought I can be an author. But yeah, from my childhood, I always wanted to be something in the field of writing, maybe a journalist or maybe a news reporter or someone who writes column in newspaper or magazines. But during my first year of college, I started reading novels. And at that time, I thought that I can even write a complete book. I can write a novel. And at that time, I knew that I want to be author.
Hello. Which were the other authors that inspire you?
I read many books actually. But the first and foremost, my inspiration, or I'll call my guru, is Paulo Coelho. So I'm very much inspired from his work and whatever he writes, whatever he puts on social media, his notes, his manuscript, everything. So he inspires me a lot. Then there are other authors like Devdutt Patnaik, Ashwin Sanghi, and Amish. So there are many. Yeah.
My name is Ashil Shah. I read your book in just two sittings, okay? It was quite fast. I don't read fiction that much. I read non-fiction much, but what interested me and I read your book in just two sittings was the interaction. Nowadays, I see fiction books don't have interaction, they just have the stories. But they don't have interaction with the readers or the between two people or the stories. Okay, that inspired me. So how you differentiate your book in that sense, it was conscious decision or just the story you went ahead with?
Well, it was very conscious. When I read book, there are times when, you know, there are three big paragraphs. I might skip the paragraph. I'll just read one or two lines. But the conversation is something which we always read. The dialogues, if there are any, we'll never miss even a single dialogue. So the way I read, I thought that even other readers want to read conversation more, and that's why I put more conversations instead of more big paragraphs. I can remember everyone's of your face, so if you ask any question on Facebook, I won't be answering it. You can ask it right now.
For those who want to further read something about, I mean, she has one book and another one is coming out, but she also writes she's the co-founder of a motivational media blog, which is called Life and People, where she writes about positivity, law of attraction, spirituality, traveling and storytelling. So that's also something that you can look her up online. I repeat, the name of the blog is Life and People. That is what it is. So Savi Sharma and Life and People.
Okay, so if you are not asking questions, let me ask them questions. Okay. Okay, tell me about your favorite character from my book of verse.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Vivan.
Hi. Good. Why?
Just because he going without any telling anything and he goes.
That's why you're
traveling. Yes.
Okay, that's interesting.
Okay,
thank you. Anyone else? No one.
So I also felt that the character Vivan was sort of loosely based on this film Ye Jawani Hai Diwani of Ranbir Kapoor, in that character. Yeah, so he is also a footloose, fancy-free sort of person, Ranbir Kapoor, in that film, where he falls in love with a girl and then he just decides to take off. Rather, it was probably always meant that he will take off and it was only a matter of time. So how did it work for you? I'm sure you would have seen that film. It's all about young people. So,
yeah.
Tell me.
I feel that, you know, I and Imtiaz Ali, we share some sort of, you know, a cell. We have same in my mind. So maybe that's why we think very much similar. I won't say, like, you know, we get inspired from each other. You know, there are some points in life which you think, but it happens that someone else put it before you. And that's the point. So it was not inspired from Ranbir's character, but yeah, it was very similar to it because I always wanted to. So Vivani is also very much personal, as I said that I wanted to travel the world. I still want to travel the world. So it's very much personal, but yeah, it gets a connection with Kabir in Ye Jawani Hai Diwani. And there are many other characters of Imtiaz Ali, which it's like, you know, I think about the story and Imtiaz just make a movie out of it. So I think that, you know, maybe we have a past life connection and that works. So hopefully I think we'll make one movie together someday.
Yeah, that sounds very promising. Yes.
So any other questions? Are you scared of me? I even know Hindi and Gujarati. So there are people who say that we can't speak in English. We were quite hesitant, so we didn't ask questions. So if there is anything like this, so you can talk in Hindi, Gujarati, anything.
Yeah, she's talking in English because I am more comfortable with English.
Yeah. Huh? So please.
How do you select the name of the characters?
Name of the characters, you know, I feel that once the story is out, each of us connect with the characters, and the characters' name are something which are always in our mind. Whenever I think about that story, the name Meera, Vivan, they'll strike us. So I think thought about the characters' name, it was like, you know, very much after brainstorming. And the characters' name, each of my characters' name, they relate to each other. They're correlated, like Meera and Vivan. Vivan means Krishna and Meera. So Meera and Vivan, they had their connections. And then there's Kabir. Kabir, the Sufi saint. So, you know, he is very calm and he has his own philosophy. Then there's Nisha. Nisha means night. So when Sufi saints are there, night is their time. They think in night and, you know, their thoughts, they come alive at night. So that's how the characters are so much related to each other. Then there's Mr. Arjun Mehra, the author who's, you know, who give them the guidance to Meera and Vivan. So if you see in Mahabharata, that's Krishna who gave guidance to Arjun. So here it's metaphor, like it's ironic that, you know, Arjun is given some guidance to Krishna. So that's how I, you know, worked upon the names of my characters. Anyone else?
Savi, is there anything else?
Yes, sir.
Please go ahead.
Hello, ma'am.
Hello.
How do you deal with writer's block?
Touchwood, but I never came across and I never, you know, felt a writer's block till now. But yeah, there are times when I feel that, you know, how should I put that feelings into words and make it very simple. So at that time, I read lots of books and I watch movies. And that's how I get back to my creative zone and I get ideas.
There is a little announcement. Sorry, we'll just take half a minute. Diamond Mines across the floor. Jaya Pruik session chet, yeah. Atmakathana Ajwade, Dr. Praful Goradia, Manish Mehtani Sathe. A session Sharu Thawa Mache. So, Je Loko Bahar Upa Che Ne Wait Kari Raya Hoi Ke Session Kyaare Sharu Thawa Nuche. So, this is for you. A session Apchar Sharu Thai Rahu Che. So, you may please proceed there. Thank you.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
You wanted to ask something, Vilma?
No. I was in fact going to ask you that, is there anything else that you think me and the rest have not covered that you'd like to sort of bring out about, let's say, your creativity is
process.
One thing that, you know, when you have a lot of complexities going on in your mind and you can't sort yourself through, you just get stuck and then you take a break. But how do you get inspired in the first place? You said at the beginning of the session itself that your inspiration comes from just observing people. But there has to be a process in, because, you know, here we are and we are probably looking at 100, 150 people here. Now, how do you identify that? Okay, so this is the person in the red dress whose story I want to tell. Now, that is what I was trying to sort of understand, that how do you zero in on that one person, one character? Just looking at that person, or do you go beyond? Do you interact with that person? You try to understand the background of that person. How does it work for you?
See, it happens that we meet many people in life. As far as stories are concerned, I'll tell you that even for my second book, I had lots of story in my mind. It was not like I was at writer's block. I had lots of stories, but I was not able to settle on one story. And all the characters, it's not like a single person can be your character. Like my characters, all my characters are inspired from many people I have met in my life. So it happens that you meet different people and something about them touches you and you think that this particular character. This particular characteristic of this person can be in my character. So it happens like, it's not always that you interact with them. Sometimes it happens that you are just sitting and you are watching a person and he is like observing him in the way, you know, he'll call the waiter or the way he'll talk to him. So there are someone, you know, they have different style. They have their own unique style. So that style touches you and you are like, okay, this can be in my character. So it happens like that. You have to observe them, everything very clearly, and you have to read a lot. Many people ask me that I have a story, but I don't know how should I put them in words. So I always tell them, you have to read a lot. If you read a lot, you'll get the words, you know, they'll just flow from your pen. So that's the point.
In fact, the person who asked about writer's block, in fact, her story begins with a writer's block. That is what it is all about. I mean, the character Meera is not able to write a story, and that is how it basically begins. She just cannot understand what she should be writing about. So I guess that is how it sort of takes off. Yeah. Another interesting point I see here is that I, being a writer myself in a completely different genre, in newspapers, but I see how what she means about observation, and that is something we can take back for all of us from here. That to be a writer, you really need to be observant. And small things like, you know, what she said, I found it very interesting, that how a person calls a waiter. You know, it's very curious how you call, reach out to a waiter. That really says a lot about a person. And that's how you decide, so this is the guy, you know, this is the person whose characteristics I want to capture and somehow put it in my book and reproduce it. So, for all the budding writers, and I see a lot of them here, some of them ask very interesting questions. This is something for you to take back, you know, keep observing people. It could be, you know, how the person walks, how a person deals with his hair, how a person sort of his eye movements. This is very interesting. We had a lot of people from the Screenwriters Association from Bombay yesterday who write for films, and in a very different manner, but they all more or less had to say the same thing, that all their characters are inspired by people around them. There was Juhi Chaturvedi, who's written this book, Vicky Donor, the film. And she said the people that the mother-in-law, who's such a preposterous person, and another lady, the grandmother, who's such a bold character, she said they are real people in her life. Would you believe it? You know, so it's very interesting that, you know, reality is stranger than fiction. So keep your eyes and ears open and keep watching out. And who knows, one of you might be a best-selling author before you know it. Yeah.
And not even in, not only in, for writing, even if you observe people, it will help them, help you in your life also. As it said, that art imitates life and life imitates art. So they can help you even in your life. You see something like, you know, I was going to my office, and I was standing there in traffic, and there was a guy next to me. He was on his bike and he was talking to someone. And he was just saying, I think a problem to ho gayi. Ab uske baare mein hum log kyon soch rahe hain, to ye bata ki solution kya nikalna hai. Jab hum problem ke baare mein hi sochte rahenge, to fir solution to milega hi nahi. So we have to think about the solution. So simple, uska phone conversation sun ke, I was like, yeah, he said something so big. It was very small, but yeah, that was the point. We always focus on problems. We don't think that, okay, the problem is out. But now we have to think about the solution, not about the about the problem. So that's how it helps us in real life also.
I think let's keep our mind clutter-free. And since I'm talking to a very young, inspirational writer, and I've never thought of... at the age that I am, let's not get into specifics, but at the age that I am, I would have never thought that I could ever be getting into telling other people how to sort out their lives. But if at 23, Savi can do something about telling other people how to sort out their lives, there's something really much to learn from her. I'm really thankful to Savi for being here today. Thank you so much, Savi.
Thank you
so much for listening to us.
Okay, there are more questions. Can we take it? Yeah.
મેડમ એક વસ્તુ મેં ઓબ્ઝર્વ કરી છે કે ગુજરાત મતલબ કે તમે ઇંગ્લિશમાં બુક લખો તો એક કવરેજ સારું એવું મળે છે આવું મારું માનવું છે કદાચ હું ખોટો પણ હોઈ શકું તો કારણ કે એટલા બધા સ્ટેટ એટલા બધા લોકો આજે એક માઇન્ડસેટ એવો રહ્યો છે પર્ટિક્યુલરલી હું ગુજરાતની વાત કરું તો કે ઇંગ્લિશમાં જે બુક લખાય છે તો થોડીક એમાં મેચ્યોરિટી હોય યા તો કોઈને અત્યારની જનરેશનમાં યંગ જનરેશનમાં ખાસ એવું લાગે છે કે નહીં ઇંગ્લિશમાં બુક વાંચવું જોઈએ તો શું ગુજરાતીમાં ખાસ કરીને જે યંગ લોકો છે કે જે પોતાની બુક લખે છે અને એની મધર ટંગ કદાચ ગુજરાતી છે તો શું એ લોકોએ ગુજરાતી છોડી અને ઇંગ્લિશને ફોકસ કરીને ઇંગ્લિશ બુક લખવી જોઈએ પછી એ ગુજરાતીમાં કરે શું કરવું જોઈએ એ વિશે
મેં હિન્દીમાં જવાબ દઉંગી
શ્યોર
ઓકે સી હમે લગતા હૈ કે ગુજરાતી રીડર્સ નહીં હૈ બટ ટુ બી ટ્રુ ગુજરાતી રીડર્સ બહોત સારે હૈ बट इट्स अप टू यू. आप सोचो कि ठीक है मुझे पूरे इंडिया में चाहिए कि मेरी बुक पढ़नी हो, तो आप उसको गुजराती में नहीं लिख सकते. बट आपको ये लगता है कि नहीं मेरे पास जो चीज़ है मैं गुजराती में उसको बहुत अच्छे से लिख सकता हूँ. तो इट्स लाइक ना देयर आर सम मूवीज जो कि मासेस के लिए होती हैं, देयर आर सम मूवीज दैट आर फॉर क्लास. सो आपको डिसाइड करना है कि आपको मासेस के लिए लिखना है या क्लास के लिए लिखना है. तो अगर आपको ये लगता है कि नहीं मैं कोई चीज़ बहुत अच्छे से गुजराती में लिख सकता हूँ और वो लोगों को छू सकती है, तो आपको गुजराती में ही लिखना चाहिए. गुजराती रीडर्स बहुत सारे हैं, कम नहीं है. गुजरात बहुत बड़ा है एंड गुजरात की पॉपुलेशन भी बहुत है, लोग पढ़ते हैं गुजराती बुक्स.
इमना जवाब में हूँ एक उमेरो करीश कि गुजराती के भाषा अंग्रेजी हो गुजराती हो बीजी कोई भी भाषा मात्र एक माध्यम है. આપણે તમારો આઈડિયા તમે શું કહેવા માગો છો એ કમ્યુનિકેટ કરવું જરૂરી છે. જેમ કે સવિની જે બુક છે, આઈ સવિ કરેક્ટ મી ઇફ આઈ એમ રોંગ, વિચ સિટી ઇઝ ઇટ બેઝડ ઇન? ઇઝ ઇટ બેઝડ ઇન બોમ્બે સ્પેસિફિકલી?
ઇન પુણે.
પુણે, ઓકે. બટ એની ચોપડી તમે વાંચશો તો એ લખે છે પુણેમાં આ જગ્યા આ જગ્યા આ જગ્યા. બટ ઇટ કુડ બી રિપ્લેસ વિથ એની સિટી ઇન ધ વર્લ્ડ. એકચ્યુઅલી ઇન ધ વર્લ્ડ આઈ એમ સેઇંગ. એવું નથી કે ખાસ યા કે પુણેમાં જ છે, તો પ્રોબેબલી ફોર હર રીઝન્સ દેટ શી વોન્ટેડ ઇટ ટુ બી સેટ ઇન પુણે. હવે તમે એ સ્ટોરીને અમદાવાદમાં લોકોને રાઇટરને પોતાની વ્યક્ત કરી શકાય જો ગુજરાતીમાં સારું ગુજરાતીમાં લખો એન્ડ દેન યુ ટ્રાન્સલેટેડ ઇન ઇંગ્લિશ. આજે ટ્રાન્સલેટર્સમાં ક્યાં એ છે? સો ભાષા ઇઝ અ મ્યોર માધ્યમ. Your what your thought, your concept, your idea is very important, and this is a discussion and question answers that we keep having on this platform very often, and I'm very happy to do it again and again. So thanks for that question. Really? Yes,
yes sir.
Where do you write writing process?
Sir,
please
just put the mic. Ma'am, aap pen aur kagaz se likhte hai ki direct computer pe likhte hai?
Pen aur kagaz. मतलब पेन और कागज़ मेरी डायरी रहती है हमेशा मेरे पास, और मैं हमेशा सबसे पहले उसमें लिखती हूँ, उसके बाद कंप्यूटर में.
रियली दैट्स न्यूज़. आई मीन फॉर समबडी हु रिलाइज ऑन सोशल मीडिया, यू राइट ऑन अ पेन एंड पेपर?
या बिकॉज़ आई फील दैट माय थॉट्स फ्लो व्हेन आई एम विद माय
एंड देन हाउ डू यू ट्रांसक्राइब देम इनटू अ कंप्यूटर स्क्रीन?
लाइक
व्हेन यू टाइप इट,
या द थिंग्स आर द मेन थॉट्स, यू नो द प्राइमरी थॉट्स. I'll write them during daytime whenever where I am. My always in my purse there's a diary, small diary and my pen. Or if there's not a diary, I'll write on tissue paper, but I'll write on a pen, on paper, I'll use that. Okay. And at night, I just type them on my laptop.
Okay. Yeah.
Ma'am, do you think that someone could be a writer if they don't feel emotions strongly?
It's up to you. See, if you want to express emotions, you have to feel them. It's not necessary that you experience everything, but you have to feel them. So if you have to feel the emotions, without feeling you can't express, because you need to express emotions. Agar aap likh rahe ho that a child is crying, so you have to feel and you have to express, just as an author said that, you know, don't tell me that it's night, show me the moon moonlight falling from my window. So you'll have to write, you have to explain the person, that the reader, that the child is crying and how he is feeling.
But for that, a writer should feel it strongly. If he is not able to do, will he become a writer?
You can always develop something. You can't say that you can't feel, so you can become. You can develop it, na? If you really want to be a writer, you can develop some habits. Read lots of books, that will help you. When you read, it helps you how a person is describing something. And that's how you can, you know, inbuilt in your yourself. Did you get the answer?
Yeah,
and I hope you'll develop it and you'll write your book.
Ma'am, one more question. Yeah, like, sure. Do you write any secrets in your book that only a few readers will understand? Any secrets related to your life inside the book that only a reader will understand?
See, as I said, that my book is very much personal. It's like, you know, for every author, there are some points in the book that are very much personal. And what connects with a reader and a writer, between a reader and a writer, are the things which are personal. So, you know, you will get my, about Savi, you will get many things in the book. But that's how, you'll have to feel the book. You'll have to feel the character's journey, and then only you can understand it.
All right. Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome.
Ma'am, for someone who you promoted your book through Facebook, right? So why didn't you think of writing the book online? There are sites to write online.
Personally, I like the feel of the paper. I like the smell of the paper. So I wanted my book to be in hand because there are many people who want to read the book in their hand. They want to smell the paper. And that's why I, you know, use. Because online, not everyone read online. There are people who will still pick up a paperback and read from this. That's why I published it.
But there's a larger scale. You wanted your book to be on a large scale. So why not online?
It's available on Kindle also. It's on both the portals. So why only stuck to one portal when you can have both the thing at the same time?
So I'll say this, that you are a little younger than her, and that is where we are already seeing a little generational difference. Why waste paper, right? So that's where it's already beginning, right? I can't imagine a book if it's not printed. It's not a book.
That's true.
So yeah, that's the interesting part. So yes, just before we take that, once again, I'll make a little announcement. It's about the session in the Diamond Mine has already started. Anybody who wants to go there, Dr. Praful Gorodia, who's in conversation with Manish Mehta, it's called Atmakathana Ajwade. It's already started there. Anybody who wants to move there, please, you can move it now.
Hello, ma'am. I have already completed one book, but I doubt in a language is in English. So can what I do, how further?
You can contact an editor for, yes, initially maybe your school or college professor. You can ask them to read the book and correct it. They can always correct. There are editors to edit your book. Even my book is edited by editors. Because even while writing, I make mistakes. Because when you are thinking something, there may be a point when you are thinking and your words are just flowing and you can't understand that I'm making a mistake. So there are always editor to correct that. That's not a point to stop you.
But I have dared to use expose from others and front of others. Then
then your book can be only in your cupboard.
That is where you should
have to be you have to be confident and you have to believe in yourself.
Yes.
That is why you have to look at Savi and think that, you know, if she can have so much confidence in her story and her book, then why can't you? That's why she's here. For all of you to give you confidence that it's all about believing in yourself, that you have a story to tell. Everybody has a story to tell and you can tell it.
And each and every one of us has fears inside us. But we have to, you know, overcome them and we have to get ahead of them. Dar ke aage jeet hai.
Yes. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
So yeah, I'll let that be the last question.
Ma'am, when you started writing your book, there are like thousands of people writing on similar topics. So when you started writing, did you feel or did competition scare you when you started writing your book?
Never actually. I started writing for myself. I write my stories for myself. And as far as competition is, Jumana mentioned that, you know, my character is very much similar to Ye Jawani Hai Diwani. So most of us have seen the movie, but still I wrote about it because I know that there is something in my story which is very different from them. So we have to trust yourself. And how you mentioned, one of the authors has said that, you know, even in the movie Tamasha, if you have seen, ki kahaniya to sadiyon se ek hi chali aa rahi hai. Everything has already been written, already been told. But we need to write it again and again for every generation to feel it. Because har koi ek hi bhasha nahi samajh sakta. We need to just change it and we need to write something for someone. Because everyone can't just understand one single thing. So you just have to trust yourself.
There are seven types of stories. This is the seven emotions and seven types of stories, which is what Shakespeare wrote all those years ago, and it probably ended there. And he challenged that nobody can come out with a theme or for a story out of these. And since then, there have been, I think, innumerable stories written, innumerable books written, innumerable movies made, and they continue to be made. It's just that there is a story which Shakespeare writes, which is in a Hamlet, in English, in an English Hamlet, and Savi writes probably a similar story, not the same story, but in a cafe in Surat, which is, you know, fictionally based in Pune. So I think that's all there is to it, and people still read the book, people still buy the book. So it's just about how you write it, how you present it. It's just the context that changes. So contemporize your book. That's what I'm learning from Savi and her success. just as much in the local new context that you can get. And in fact, adding to his query about the language, in fact, the more regional flavor that you have in your book, there is more probability of it appealing to a larger audience, because people want to read about other regions, people want to know about other areas. So if you are a Gujarati, in whichever language you choose to write in, but if you write about Gujarat, people will pick up your book, people will love to read about it. But it has to be a true reflection, not a... Yeah.
And it's about how you write.
Of course, it's always about, that's what the writer comes in.
Yeah. It was Ramayana, even in Ramayana Mahabharata, we know the story. But when some authors come with a different style and something, we'll definitely reread it, even though we know, and we'll feel it new. We won't feel, yeah, we know that after this, this will happen. We always go with the flow and we always enjoy the thing. So that's what you want. You know, you have to be special in your style.
Two of the top-selling authors in India, Devdutt Patnaik and Amish Tripathi, who write in English, are writing only about Indian mythology. Now tell me, which one of you here hasn't read about what Amish has to write about? Who did not know about Shiva before Amish wrote the book? Who did not know? Can anyone please put up their hands and say? And if I ask the same question, how many of you read the Meluha, Amish's first book? I think probably a lot of hands will go up. That, including me. And I knew what Amish is going to, what's the story. So yeah, I think that answers your question. There are only so many stories to tell. It's about how you tell your story. Okay, so this is actually the very last question. She's already here. But yeah.
Hello, ma'am.
Hello.
It is believed that a writer influences a generation. What do you believe? How would you be influencing a generation like us people?
Have you read my book?
No, I have not got chance.
So I think you'll get the answer after reading my book. And the thing is, you know, you never, today's generation, if I talk about specifically, we don't like when someone, you know, someone commands us and someone tells them that this is wrong, this is right. But if we put ourselves in a situation and we show them that, okay, this is the situation I'm facing, and I think this is the correct path, they'll get it. And they'll think, okay, even I'm at the same point and I should do it. So it inspires different people with different things. Like my story, a few of my readers said that we were on a suicide point, but your story stopped us to commit suicide and to live life again. So it's always different things by which you can inspire people. And my story, I think it's inspiring many people. That's what my readers say. So yeah, I think if you will read my book, you'll come to know that what's in my story and if it can inspire you or not.
You want to ask your question?
Yeah,
go ahead. That is really the very last question.
Hi ma'am. Can you say something about your next venture?
I already answered it. I think you're late.
Yeah.
Okay, so I won't disclose more as of now. My book is coming on 14th Feb 2017. It is Valentine's. And it's a story, again, an inspirational tale about following your dreams and to giving life a chance, to take the step which you're always afraid to take. So yeah, it will inspire you in many points, and even that is very much personal to me. Not very much real maybe, but it's very much personal from my personal experiences and thoughts. And you'll have to wait more for more. Yeah.
So yeah, on that note, I'll sum it up. Just to reiterate, we've released a book, Darek Ni Ek Varta Hoi Che, which is the Gujarati translation of her English book, Everyone Has a Story. Please do pick it up. The books are available on the stands at Nav Bharat Store, the Gujarati translation, and as well as the English,
as well as the English book.
Yes, Westland is the publisher for the English translation, English original, and Nav Bharat for the Gujarati one. Thank you very much for being here today. You have a good day.
Thank you, Jumana. Thank you, Savi.